the usual Ludiak problem, isn't there?
I managed to get a bed for the first time ever at Ludiak this time.
Bed?
Yeah.
Wow. Cool.
I must have been the first person in it as well, so that was nice.
If you're new to PBP and you're riding the 90-hour option, Ludiak is where you'll arrive on your second night. There are sleeping mats and blankets in the sports hall, and the feeding facilities are good, until it's overwhelmed at about midnight. And it's like this for the next 4 hours.
Oh my god! Are these in any kind of order, do you know? Could you explain to me?
Hey, yes, it will. A lot better than some of the poor souls here, I think.
Okay.
Okay, I shall film you setting off. Good luck. Yeah, see you later.
Really?
PBP is a major challenge. People respond to that challenge in different ways. One response is to make plans. Now, most of those plans involve sleeping at Ludiak, and for most people that works out. But for a large number, this is how they'll remember it. Very few actually abandon those plans, I think, because they're afraid of the unknown. All they really know is that the next control is at Kahe, and that's 75 kilometres further on. Any pictures or film of PBP will show the odd person asleep in a fairly unlikely place. This is the scale of the Ludiak problem. Yet the service you get for them volunteers is second to none. I think they're great.
I have very focal lenses inside my glasses, and as soon as it starts to rain, they all mist up.
Right.
So when it's raining, I can't wear my glasses. That means I can't see any route signs, I can't see any anything at all.
Mm.
And I was following some of these American riders that have got luminous jackets, and because my vision was blurred, the red lights were all streaky, and then these luminous jackets were all billowed up, which just gave it just looked like it was from Third Galaxy or somewhere else. I wasn't on Earth. But I mean, I could say to myself that was a rider, but it just the way it was appearing, and you had all of these movements, and of course the reflective stripes going up and down as well.
Right.
And you know, you just couldn't photograph anything like that. You'd need a weird imagination in order to be able to replicate it.
Great, eh?
Let it shine on me. Let it shine.
Gorgeous bowl of soup.
And especially
definitely to recommend, best kept secret of the whole.
It is, isn't it? Yep. Especially after the hell of Ludiak.
Queue around the block for sleep time.
Yeah. Queue's gone down, but there are people just to sleep outside under space blankets now.
Don't tell anybody about here.
Let it shine. Did you start Tuesday morning then?
Oh god, no. No, I'm silly, but I'm not that silly. No, this is my first time, 90 hours.
Right.
Just saying, I've by accident taken all the worry out of Ludiak.
Yeah.
I have my father-in-law there with 10 of them.
Ah, right.
So I just rolled in knowing that I was going to get 2.5 hours.
Yeah.
And I'll get another 5 or 6 tonight.
And
And, I'll play now, it's okay.
And people were still queuing up to get a bed after we left.
And you had 4 hours there, blind.
So I think they're going to be running it close to the wire.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's fine.
I was offering you out then, Bruce.
Hey, book one.
Goodbye.
Let your light from the light of shine on. I know I've got religion and I ain't ashamed. Let your light from the light of shine on me. Angels in heaven down the road.
Hey, Steve.
On Monday night, we'd started out from the edge of Paris, in the heart of a fiercely modern, technocratic France. We could have been anywhere in the world. Now, on Wednesday morning, we're so far west that the sun was rising 20 minutes later, and we were in La France Profonde, a place where cyclists were provided with a ride-in bar for a wine and a beer at 6 in the morning.
How's it going then?
Not good.
Is it not?
We've not really built up enough time to get any sleep, so I'm just struggling to stay awake at the moment.
What, both of you, right?
Well, just me, really.
Oh, right, OK. Get in there.
Sleep deprivation is a funny thing. It hits people in different ways. I was on caffeine gum and coffee to compensate for only 2 hours sleep in the last two nights. And you do start to get a bit jittery. It's also about now that dogs start to take an interest in over 4,000 rather smelly people.
Let your light